Welcome to another video of the comic series. It's me again. Today I'm talking about why couldn't Anakin use Force Heal to save Padme? I've already uploaded the recap of the Star Wars series. If you haven't yet seen the story, and you don't remember, please go watch it with the link below. Let's get started. Seeing this ability front and center in The Rise of Skywalkers brought some questions about the whole prequel series struggle, and it seems to have created a bit of a continuity issue. Today, we'll look at this ability to try to resolve this question to figure out why Anakin himself couldn't save Padme. Now, Force Heal was also canonized by Mandalorian Season 1, Episode 7, where the kid uses the power to save Carl Weathers' character, Greef Karga. The Force ability was made even more popular a few days later when The Rise of Skywalker turned out to be a major plot point for the film, even though the Mandalorian canonized this power and The Rise of Skywalkers is an ability that the Legends actually originated. Several years before this mid-calm down, it's important to note that when The Sith Revenge came out, these materials were already canon, which begs the question of why Anakin did not use Force Healing to save Padme. So, why didn't Anakin think to use this? Well, likely, he didn't know the ability existed at all. So, to speak about why the Jedi should have hidden this knowledge from Anakin, we first have to consider how Force Heal functions and how the main characters acquired this skill, as we remember from the Emergence of the Skywalkers. Force Heal operates by moving life force from one human to another, similar to how Palpatine took life force from Padme to keep Vader alive. Now learn that Luke learned this skill from the ancient Jedi texts that were written long before the Jedi's collapse and compiled by Luke after the Jedi's return. We also see the child using this skill in The Mandalorian, but he appears to lower it all on his own without having learned it from any Jedi book. And if the child could do so with almost no instruction, then wouldn't Anakin know how to use this skill? It's strange, but Luke explicitly mentions this, or at least this idea, in The Secrets of the Jedi, a document written by Luke sometime before the Return of the Jedi, and his death in The Last Jedi on Locke 2. In that book, he says using the Force properly is all about balance, and some Force users, particularly Force-sensitive children, know where the Jedi, as younglings, can tap into its energy without an obvious alignment to either side of the Force. It simply flows through them in their purest form, based on the constant struggles I've seen and witnessed between the light and the dark sides of the Force. Perhaps their innate neutrality can teach us all a valuable lesson. And essentially, what Luke is saying is that kids, and particularly Force-sensitive kids, have inherent neutrality. In case he's concerned about the fact that kids will tap into the energy in balance or without even beginning in harmony or turning towards the light or the dark, they just have the power, which is why the child will just tap into Force Heal without any clear experience or knowledge of what he or she is doing. Only needs Greef Karga to be better. So he places his hand on him and heals Greef Karga. So again, why wouldn't Anakin? Well, he's an adult, which means he would believe that he knows how the Force works, or at least believes that he has to learn an ability to use it, and this idea just tapping into the Force and letting it flow through him is innately childlike, at least according to Luke, and therefore he would not have the ability to do it. But what we have seen of the child, I think it's obvious that he can also let the energy pass into him in a manner that other people don't learn, or something because of their perceptions or understandings. And the question is, however, whether the ancient Jedi learned how to Force Heal, then it wouldn't be a teachable skill during the Republic period. Healing seems to be an innately light-faced thing to do. Right, well, I think the answer comes from what we know of the Jedi during the era of the Clone Wars. Jedi were overzealous in their fear of attachments, believing that attachments always led to the dark side. It can sort of start to make sense why Force Healing would be discouraged, since it allows the Jedi to try to hold on to things rather than let them die. Force Healing will encourage you to continue to hang on to stuff instead of letting it go and trusting the Force when it's their time. This seems to go against the Jedi's teachings during the prequels period. In the end, I don't think the Jedi practice force healing because it's a form of connection. You had to be attached to something to want to keep it alive. Now, fundamentally, I believe that this undermines the purpose of the Jedi, which is to protect and enforce the light within the galaxy, and that includes the preservation of life, not just simply trusting in the will of the Force. When it's time for things to die, we see this mentality show up in the Clone Wars, with characters like Luminaire unduly just accepting death and letting it happen, and refusing to try to save people because she wants to be okay with it. If the Force determines when it's time for you to die, I think the ancient Jedi used this Force-restoring power because they felt that their duty was to defend life. But with a mindset of fear, of commitment, this construction of a wall around the law, this went on rising and progressing. They began cutting off any chance to push any instruction or lesson that could allow you to hold on to things that are not yours or that it's time to let go. Perhaps that would explain why the Jedi will start preventing the use of Force healing over time. And I want to point out that none of this is proven. It's just a sort of theoretical hypothesis on why Jedi should be blocking the Force healing power. We know it exists in the Legends, and we know it remains in canon. And even Anakin is oblivious of it in the prequels. Ultimately, I don't think any of this was the intention of the creators of Star Wars, whether the current ones or George Lucas, because I think it makes enough sense and answers enough questions that it can at least sit in my head canon as the reason why Anakin doesn't use Force healing, and is consistent with the character and with the message of Star Wars and what we know of the Jedi during the era of their fall. But these are my opinions, not a fact-driven film. It's video-based, focused on what we hear about Star Wars. But the assumptions are all mine, and I want to hear if you guys think that you agree with me. Do you believe that Force healing was prohibited because it helps people to hang on to things even though it's time for them to be let go? Or do you think there's another explanation why the Jedi somehow lost this power to Force heal? That was a review of the comic series, Why Couldn't Anakin Use Force Healing to Save Padme? Hope you enjoyed this comic. I'm going to upload all other topics as well. Remember to like and subscribe, and thanks for watching. See you in the next one.